ain't gonna jump himself at 140. And it makes no sense for him to go to 147. Tank is shorter than me. Tank has no
height. Yeah, but I've seen
his power not gonna be done at 147, Ellie.
I've seen him spar 47, 54, 60, and 60, and even 75 guys, and he does really good. And these are guys ranked top 10.
Tank is just Ellie setback. I sparred a super heavyweight, and I clipped him. That don't mean I'm gonna get in a real fight and fight him. Understand what I'm saying? Like, no, I don't. Like I said, I don't want him to do an AB.
By the way, congratulations to Broner. I just spoke to him 5 minutes ago before we jumped here on the live. Adrian's doing good. He's very soon getting back in the gym. He's staying right where he left off.
That's great. You know everybody support AB, man. You know everybody love AB. You gotta love AB.
You know what's crazy? After his fight, he was trending number one in the U.S., more than NBA, more than any other MMA, other boxing. And he didn't fight anybody famous. Imagine if Broner fights a famous name, Keyshawn. This is with nobody famous, he was trending.
For real?
Yep. It's a big compliment.
Red Catch, man. You get ready, Red Catch.
Red Catch Spark Tank.
Yeah, Red Catch Spark Tank. We remember that.
Red Catch is a good dude. He's a hard worker. He's very dedicated.
Right. That's what I'm saying. Red Catch at his best right now, man.
I want to see him and Adrian. That would be a big fight.
Somebody said AB is embarrassing. Y'all don't know boxing. See, that's going back to us when I was saying, y'all don't know what these fighters really come from and then go through to get to the point they're at. Like you got to look at the bigger picture. You can't look at AB is showing his true self. A lot of these fighters out here, hide behind the lights. They talk on camera a certain way, but when they get around their immediate family, they act totally different. What you see out of AB is how he is personally. Like, you got to respect that. If you don't respect that, you're probably not real with yourself. Or you just don't understand.
Listen, Adrian's not a hater. He loves everybody. He talks smack because it's marketing and it sells. But in the end of the day, you saw when Oscar Valdez knocked out Burchett, he walked up to him and he said, "You'll be back. You'll be a champ again." And that's what boxing's all about. You can beef with people. I know you want to fight Rollies and you want to beat him in the ring or you want to fight him, but you have no bad feelings. It's not beef. It's not hate.
Nah, heck nah. It's not like I want to go in there and kill him or anything like that. Nah, I just want to fight him.
Okay. By the way, Tevin Farmer said he's moving up to 135. What do you think about Tevin and Rowley?
I think Tevin Farmer moved up to 135 because he didn't want to fight Shakur and get all that mix. But going up to 135 fighting Rowley, I think Tevin Farmer can pull that off.
What about Tevin and Tank? If Tevin wins a belt and he's a champion at 35, him and Tank, what do you think?
I mean, I wouldn't say that fight makes no sense, but we know what's going to happen with that fight. Tevin Farmer, Tevin Farmer, I feel like he's going to get knocked out. I love to fight Tevin Farmer. Like, sometime next year when I start going 10 rounds, 12-round fight for a belt, Tevin Farmer. Come here, Tevin Farmer. I'd love to fight you.
You're fighting tomorrow. Your first fight, what, 6 rounds?
Yeah, I'm fighting 6.
That's crazy. Most people turn pro, they have 4, and they stay at 4 for like 4 or 5 fights. You're going to go 6, 8, 10.
That's what you said, Ellie.
We'll see. But how excited are you? Turning pro is a big deal. You could have stayed amateur. You could have gone to the Olympics. You could have won a gold medal. Everybody had you as a favorite to win. But now you're fighting on a Canelo card, which is huge. And what goes through your mind?
For I'm excited. I'm just excited to fight. Like, I wouldn't say I don't care that I'm pro and all that, but I'm just blocking. Like, I'm blocking all of that unnecessary stuff out. Now I'm just really excited to fight. Like, I didn't fight in a year. I didn't fight in a year and 2 months, Ellie. You feel what I'm saying? I'm really just excited to fight. And the main thing I focus on is just staying focused and getting in the ring and getting comfortable. I'm a fighter where as soon as I get comfortable, it's over with for anybody. Understand what I'm saying? And I'm also a type of fighter where I know how to control the fight. I learned that in the amateurs, the reason why I was performing so great with them top-notch fighters in the amateurs. So once I get comfortable in the ring, all that unnecessary stuff, me being pro, 8-ounce gloves, the crowd, different environment, all that stuff doesn't mean nothing because a fight is a fight.
People on the live want to know, what's your relationship with Eddie Hearn? Have you ever met Eddie or spoke to Eddie?
Now, honestly, I never met Ellie, but he sounded like a great man through the DMs. You know what I'm saying? He's like a person that's very interactive with social media. And he been making sure I have people, like, if I can have people in the locker room, like certain fighters that's coming out to see me. He just been making sure I'm in good all the way around. Understand what I'm saying? That he making me feel like I'm at home, even though I'm still independent. So I really appreciate Eddie. You know what I'm saying? And I appreciate Eddie.
He knows you. I'm sure he did his homework. I'm sure he understands what he has on his hands for this fight. Does he know your boxing? Has he done his homework?
Oh, yeah, definitely. He like you said, he knows. Understand what I'm saying? He also loved the kid, Mark Castro. Understand what I'm saying? Shout out Mark Castro, man. He definitely know me and him is definitely the future of boxing. He hoping I can be the future of the zone boxing, too, alongside with Devin Haney at 135. Shout out Devin Haney and his dad.
What if you have to fight Devin?
I mean, ain't no if I have to fight him, it's gonna be like a fight, like you said, Rolly. Ain't no beef, all business. I would love to fight Devin. I never been in the ring with Devin. I never sparred Devin. Understand really? What I'm saying? So it's gonna be fresh on both ends. Understand what I'm saying? I think that would be a hell of a fight. I think that's a fight the fans would actually want.
Okay, let me ask you this from a psychological standpoint. Would you want to spar him to know what would be like fighting him, or would you want not to spar him and just find out on fight night?
It don't matter. It really don't matter at this point, Ellie. I just sparred so many world champions, so many Olympic champions. I just sparred a Cuban the other day. He was a Cuban champion out in Cuba. He a professional fighter right now. I ain't going to say the name. But my last sparring session before I came into the bubble, I dropped him. Like, I'm just the type of fighter I feel like I'm very confident in myself, but I just feel like I'm the type of fighter. I'm just ready for anything. I done fought internationally so many times. I done seen every style. I'm just around good energy, good champions. Understand what I'm saying? Jared Anderson, top prospects I'm around. I'm a type of person that just soak all that in and just take my game to the next level. So, smart Devin Haney or not, it really doesn't matter. I'm going to come out with the victory if I ever fight him.
People in the live want to know if you ever sparred Terrence Crawford.
Yeah, I sparred Terrence Crawford right before I went to the Pan American Games.
What was that like for you?
Man, that motherfucker, man. Like, he was a person I really could not get my rocks off of him. Like, I could not hit him the way I wanted to hit him. Like, when he was orthodox, like, I was more worried about his power, right? But when he turned southpaw, I was just more worried about me running into something. Like, he just always kept me on my toes, and he really humbled my game. Like, with me and Shakur, we spar a lot, so certain stuff we know not to do with each other. But Terrence Crawford was new to me. Understand what I'm saying? So it made me see, like, how much of a kid I still was. Understand what I'm saying? In the ring. So, like, I took that and I ran with it. Understand what I'm saying? I took that and I ran with it. I was like, nah, if we ever do spar against Terrence Crawford, you're going to see a different side of me, first of all. But other than that, I'm going to build off this. I'm going to grow off this. I'm going to remember this experience.
There's a lot of talk of him fighting either Pacquiao or Sean Porter. I don't think he fights Pacquiao next. So what do you think about Sean Porter, Terrence Crawford?
I think that's a statement maker. I think, especially being a fight that him and Sean Porter and Errol Spence was so great and it was so competitive. I think if Terrence Crawford can somewhat raise the bar in that fight, you know what I'm saying? It'd be a statement maker. You know what I'm saying? It'll quiet a lot of people. And I feel like if they can make that fight happen, then they can definitely make the Errol Spence fight happen. And I also feel like, well, at the same time though, Ellie, let me back up a little bit. Even if they do make that Sean Porter and Terrence Crawford fight happen, and he makes a statement, and Terrence Crawford makes a statement, I feel like Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford, it's going to be an even harder fight to make. Because then they really feel like it's even. Who's going to be the A side? Who's going to be the B side? Understand what I'm saying? Like, it's really going to be confrontation within that.
But even I don't think the fight happens. I don't think we see Crawford Spence ever.
Nah, I don't think it is.
They want to know, why do you have a towel on your head? You want to explain to them how fighters make weight or no?
Man, I got the bath. Then, you know, I took a shower, so I got hella hair, so my hair just be soaked. So I just keep a towel on my head.
Well, fighters lose weight. Now, he's in a bubble. He can't go to the gym. He can't leave his room until tomorrow night. So when I was in the bubble, the first bubble, there was a fighter over my head who jumped rope for 8 straight hours because there's nothing else you could do. So what Keyshawn just did, he just soaked himself in a tub, and that helps you lose weight.
Yeah, that actually probably – I ain't look at my weight before I got in the bath because that really be, like, messing up my head sometimes, especially if I'm heavy. But I got out, I was only 4 pounds over. I was 2 pounds over yesterday. But I didn't train all day today, you know, so.
You didn't train, and also it's a little hard to keep your diet when you're stuck in a room.
Word,
And listen, maybe in a couple of years, maybe in 1 year, you'll be a superstar. You'll be one of the biggest names in boxing. They're going to have for you a grand suite with a treadmill, a weight. But you're not there yet, so you're not going to have all that in your room. Your room is probably just a bed, and that's it.
I mean, Ellie, it don't matter to me, man. I come from nothing. So just having what I have right now is enough for me. Understand what I'm saying?
No, absolutely. I'm just saying, like, people think, like, you may have all this accessible to gym or workout material. You don't right now. You right. will in the future, and maybe tomorrow or tomorrow night or maybe Thursday. Wait, tomorrow is Tuesday. So Wednesday you can hit the gym, correct?